it is of great interest for Egypt to see this rapidly Arab nation secure.
Yeah. It's good that you started your program with what happened in France yesterday.
Right.
The speaker was talking from the spiritual point of view and the religious point of view. But as you said, we have to start from the strategic perspective. Libya is not an ordinary country, in my opinion.
Right.
Libya is an oil country, first of all.
Mm-hmm.
Not only an oil country, it's a very promising oil country.
Mm-hmm.
The reserves, the oil reserves in Libya are still abundant.
Mm-hmm.
They are not tapped because they started their oil production in the 60s. If you compare this with the Arab Peninsula, they started in the 40s and the 50s.
Mm-hmm.
Second, Libya is a Mediterranean country at the same time.
Okay.
So what happened in France yesterday may be reflected, in Libya and vice versa at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
Third, Libya is a North African country. It borders two pivotal Arab states, Egypt and Algeria.
Mm-hmm.
So this strategic importance, it aggravates the problem because, you know, what happens in Libya, as you said, the militias now are working there, they have kind of a free hand.
Mm-hmm.
In the same time, there is this political division in Libya. Yes,
mm-hmm.
we have two types of governments. One of them was a past government, the second is now trying to work and to win. It's an elected government, elected parliament,
mm-hmm.
and therefore, if you started with this government, you have to provide the people there who are responsible for the situation with a lot of things. First of all, political support.
Mm-hmm.
Second, they need, in my opinion, a military support.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not talking about repetition of the NATO intervention, which was something deplorable in my opinion,
mm-hmm.
because it interfered, it destroyed the Qaddafi regime, okay, no problem, but at the same time, they left Libya in this chaos,
mm-hmm.
in this chaotic problem. To the extent that there are some observers, which I know, which I have reading about, they think that it was something deliberate. I don't care about that, but what happened now on the ground is that Libya is a military, mm-hmm. militarized, not the government, I mean, but the militias. At the same time, we have a lot of militias. There are the religious militias,
mm-hmm.
there are the, now we have something new. There is the oil militias,
mm-hmm.
who are producing oil, selling oil in spot markets,
mm-hmm.
so they have a lot of money, and they are emulated, and maybe they are emulating the Daesh people in Kirkuk in Iraq,
mm-hmm.
and therefore this case reflects on what I call, what it's now known, reflects on the national security of Egypt in particular. Why?
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, the borders between Egypt and Libya are so vast,
right.
they cannot be guarded at all,
mm-hmm.
because it's just barren, a part of the Sahara, of the African Sahara. In the same time, it is not only, the problem is not only inside Libya, there is this kind of smuggling of arms across our borders to the hinterland of Egypt, especially in Upper Egypt. This reflects negatively on the terrorism in Egypt, and we now are living the manifestations, very deplorable manifestations in this respect. In the same time, Libya, as part of the African Sahara, may be a home for other extremists coming from sub-Saharan Africa, like Boko Haram, like the Qaeda in the Maghreb, in the Islamic Maghreb. All these things are perspectives to which we have to look in cool-headed attitude towards what's going on in Libya.
Right. Well, Libya, Dr. Karim, as Professor Kholy has said, is not an ordinary country. And what happens in France is reflecting in Libya, yes, this sense of terrorism. The professor is talking about not only militias, namely those who are coordinating or collaborating with Daesh, but there are own militias as well. How can the situation be in control, bearing into consideration this scenario?
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. From a geopolitical point of view, what is happening in Libya now, we call it a failed state situation, which means there is no central government that can control the state of Libya and can take decisions and take control of the border, terrorism and so on. And this means that civilians and inhabitants of Libya cannot live an urban life. They are considered in a conflict zone or war zone. This have resulted in the appearance of different militias with different ideologies and with different interest group. Here we can call like smuggling and different types of arms or supporting different extremist views and so on.
Mm-hmm.
So unless there is a central government that can take a decision and can take control in Libya, this means that this type of militias will expand, and this type of militias can impact or it will harm the surrounding countries like Egypt, like Algeria, like Morocco, like Chad and other surrounding countries. In the same time, Libya will be the haven of terrorism. Why? Because there is no border, there is no control, anything can be smuggled there, anything can be hidden there. So this means that this can be a haven for, as my colleague said, that Boko Haram can take it as a base for smuggling, Daesh in, or ISIS in Iraq or Syria can have some kind of room. Time, such type of threat is not threatening Egypt and Algeria only, it will threat the south border of Europe, because France and Italy and Sicily is very near from Libya, and Libya is a Mediterranean country, and there is an ease of access to such type of borders and harbors, so you can find smuggling of heavy armors, you can find terrorist groups that can go for specific operations inside Europe or inside Egypt or inside Algeria, like we have seen in Farafra and so on. So what happened yesterday in France, it can be translated that terrorist doesn't have a country.
Or a religion.
And doesn't have a religion. So when you are creating, having such type of militias, this means that these militias will grow. These militias will have much more severe impact on the surrounding country and the international community, because at the same time Libya is facing the naval lines inside the Mediterranean, so they can have threatening attacks on this lines. It can threaten the supply of oil, the supply of gas. Also in the same time, the borders of Egypt and Algeria is very, very big to be controlled for such type of militias. Link with other militias groups inside Western Africa would be easy, because the southern border of Libya is very open. It is not controlled. So unless the international community make a real effort to support a central government in Libya to protect first the civilian of Libya, the Libyan people, protect the border of Libya, and start to control such type of militias, as the surrounding region in North Africa will not rest in peace for a long time. And here I'm not speaking of North Africa only, I'm also speaking of South Europe, because Italy and France will be the first countries to be impacted in Europe from Libya, and Egypt and Algeria will be the top countries that will be impacted from such type of militias in Libya. So we have to focus on the national security issue in Libya as soon as possible, otherwise we face something stronger than ISIS in Iraq coming from Libya and trying to attack the borders of Egypt and Algeria, calling from whatever blah 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 they are calling.
Right, the Arab Nabil al-Arab stressed the importance of decisive action in pursuit of Libya's unity. Dr. Karim is saying that the international community should also lend a hand of help and support, and without this sense of support, the terrorists and the extremists will be actually flourishing even more. Armed terrorist operations has been targeting Libyans as well, also foreign nationals residing over there. While the Arab League expressed full support for Libya's Tobruk-based government, let's watch this report highlighting the issue, and we will be back for further discussion of Libya, the main headline, main story for the daily debate for tonight.
Arab League held an emergency meeting in Cairo Monday to discuss recent developments in Libya. The meeting came following an urgent request made by Ashour Bourchib, Libya's permanent delegate to the League. The meeting was attended by Secretary General Nabih Al Arabi and UN Arab League Special Envoy to Libya, Nasser Al Qubia. It aimed to discuss the ongoing conflict in Libya and the wave of violence that has recently gripped the country. The League condemned the recent attacks on oil storage facilities, the murder of an Egyptian doctor and his family, and the abduction of 13 Egyptian citizens by armed militias in Libya. It further expressed